Delta variant surge. Do we need a new COVID-19 vaccine? The COVID-19 Delta variant has caused a new wave in this pandemic. While vaccines are doing a great job in preventing severe disease and death, it is obvious that breakthrough infections are more common with Delta. So, many are likely wondering if this variant is demanding a new set of vaccines soon. Two main things are being explored in the battle against Delta. First, developers are analyzing if future COVID-19 vaccines must be adjusted for Delta and other new variants. And second, they are examining if these variants combined with boosters will work on Delta and other new variants. Interim findings suggest a booster of the original formula improves protection against Delta. Dr. Topol tweeted that the effectiveness of Pfizer and Moderna vaccines are as low as 50% against the Delta. That figure is based on unified data from several studies that reported vaccine effectiveness. In that tweet, Public Health England reported 88% effectiveness for Pfizer at 2 doses and 60% for AstraZeneca versus symptomatic cases. In Israel, Pfizer's effectiveness was 64%, but more recent data showed 39%, which demanded boosters. Why Delta can easily break through vaccines than previous variants? Its mutations have a far greater impact compared to other variants. Plus, antibodies from vaccines may have a higher chance of a hit or miss. According to a study in Nature, Delta's mutations in the spike proteins are a worse fit for antibodies. Vaccinated and those who developed antibodies against the original strain and Alpha variant are not quite protected against Delta, said Yiska Wiesblum at the Rockefeller University. Here's another reason, the waning efficacy. This is known in the pertussis vaccine, also known as DTaP. The protection levels are great in the first 2 years, but after that, the protection starts to decline, CDC says. This is why DTaP has a fifth dose to get the maximum protection, though the full protection only lasts around 5 years. At present, the answer is closer to launching booster shots. Data on the effectiveness of vaccines is still coming out, and scientists will use it before making a crucial decision. Remember, vaccine research is expensive, and there are still problems in the supply chain. I think we're looking at an inevitable move toward boosters, at least in higher-risk people like those of advanced age and obviously the immunocompromised, said Dr. Eric Topol at the Scripps Research Institute, per Liv Science. Visit our channel for the latest trends. Please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon for fresh content daily. Thanks for watching!